In this video, we will learn to solve the equation square root of 3 times cosecant of x minus 2 is equal to 0. Given to us, square root of 3 times cosecant of x minus 2 is equal to 0. If we take the minus 2 to right hand side of the above equation, we get square root of 3 times cosecant of x is equal to 2. Let us divide the above sides by square root of 3, so we get cosecant of x is equal to 2 upon square root of 3. Multiplying the numerator and the denominator by a common factor does not change the value of the fraction, so let us multiply the numerator and the denominator by square root of 3, so we get cosecant of x is equal to 2 times square root of 3 upon 3. As cosecant function is a periodic function with period of 2 times pi, so let us first find the solutions to the equation cosecant of x is equal to 2 times square root of 3 upon 3 in period of 0 to 2 times pi. We know value of cosecant of pi upon 3 is 2 times square root of 3 upon 3. We also know the famous trigonometry identity cosecant of pi minus a is equal to cosecant of a. The proof of the trigonometry identity is given in the video appearing in the upper right corner of this video. The link of the video is also given in the description section. Application of the above identity implies that cosecant of pi minus pi upon 3 is equal to 2 times square root of 3 upon 3. This implies cosecant of 2 times pi upon 3 is equal to 2 times square root of 3 upon 3. So, the solutions to the equation cosecant of x is equal to 2 times square root of 3 upon 3 in interval between 0 and 2 times pi are pi upon 3 and 2 times pi upon 3. Let us find the general solutions. As we know, the value of cosecant of x repeats after an interval of 2 times pi. So, the general solutions are 2 times n times pi plus pi upon 3 and 2 times n times pi plus pi minus pi upon 3, where n is an integer. Further simplification gives us the general solutions are 2 times n times pi plus pi upon 3 and 2 times n plus 1 times pi minus pi upon 3. As we know, 2 times n is an even integer and 2 times n plus 1 is an odd integer for any n. So, union of these two sets is set of integers. Also, minus 1 raised to the power of n is minus 1 if n is an odd number and plus 1 if n is an even number. So, general solution to the equation is n times pi plus minus 1 raised to the power of n times pi upon 3, where n is any integer. Thank you for being with me. I hope you like this video. Please click the like button and subscribe button. Do not forget to press the notification bell so that you get the notifications of my new videos. Share the video and do write in the comments. I am eager to listen to your thoughts. If you have any question related to the video or if you think I should make a video on any other topics in which you are interested, please write in the comments. Thank you.